Okay. Now, one minute. Am I audible to all?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is our practical setup for this practical verification of Bernoulli's theorem. Okay. And here you can observe this is the sump tank. Okay. This is the collecting tank, or you can say discharge measuring tank. And this is a tapered pipe. Like tapered pipe ahe. The क्रॉस सेक्शन एरिया आपल्याला पाहायला भेटेल. या ठिकाणी जास्त आहे हा क्रॉस सेक्शन एरिया, असं कमी कमी होत गेलाय. दिस क्रॉस सेक्शन एरिया इट हॅज डिक्रीज अप टू दिस अँड अगेन इट हॅज इन्क्रीज्ड. ओके, हिअर इट हॅज गोन ऑन इन्क्रीजिंग लाईक दिस. ओके, अँड हिअर दिस आर द प्रिझोमेट्रिक ट्यूब्स. दिस वन, दिस सेकंड, दिस इज थर्ड, फोर्थ, फिफ्थ, सिक्स्थ, अँड देर इज अ स्केल. इट हॅज बीन अटॅच्ड हिअर इन बिटवीन टू प्रिझोमेट्रिक ट्यूब्स. So here we can measure when the water will rise inside this tube. We can measure the pressure head with the help of this scale. Okay, त्याचा जो lower meniscus असतो of that water surface. Okay, या ठिकाणी concave shape मध्ये water surface चा तयार होईल, meniscus तयार होईल. तो lower meniscus जो आहे it can be taken as a for the reading purpose. Okay, here. So wherever there is a larger cross section area, the pressure head will be more and velocity head will be less. So as pressure will be more, the water will rise here more. Okay, ya tikani water che rise jast hoil. Ya tikani cross section area kami asel, wherever there is a cross section area very small, the velocity head will be more and pressure head will be less. So you can observe there very small rise in water level. It can be observed at this particular where there is a cross section area smaller, and again here the cross section area will go on increasing, and you will observe there is a more rise in water level, means pressure head will be more. So pressure head ya ठिकाणी reading भेटते. Then in our practical number one, we have to piezometric tube, measurement of pressure by using piezometric tube, that title is there in the table. With the help of this piezometric tube we measure the pressure intensity. How we measure? There we measure the pressure head, and then by using the formula P equal to gamma H, by using that formula we can find out what is the pressure intensity inside this particular pipe. Okay, ya pipe madhi pressure intensity aplyala tya thikani kadta yeu shakte. Theek aahe, so this is our task actually. Now here this is a monoblock pump. Aap pump aahe monoblock type pump, centrifugal pump. Monoblock mhanje kay? Electric motor ani pump ha doni ekas yacha varke aahe. Theek aahe, दिस मच इज द इलेक्ट्रिक मोटर. हा इलेक्ट्रिक मोटरचा पार्ट आहे, अँड पंप पार्ट इज दिस मच. हा पुढचा जो आहे, दिस इज द पंप पार्ट. ओके, दिस मच, अँड दिस इज द इलेक्ट्रिक मोटर. सो दिस इज द मोनोब्लॉक टाइप ऑफ पंप. दिस इज द सक्शन पाईप, अँड दिस इज द This is a suction pipe, and then this is the delivery pipe here. Okay, water is entering here, in going inside this tank, and this is the bypass pipe or return pipe. Okay, excess water it will flow through this pipe. So whenever we start any type of pump, at that time what we have to do, initially we have to open this bypass valve completely. A completely open thevayche jene karun सुरुवातीला पाणी हे सक्शन मधून आल्यानंतर हे कम्प्लिटली इथून बाहेर पडेल, आणि जसं आपल्याला गरज आहे त्याप्रमाणे आपण हा वॉल क्लोज करायचा आहे. आय थिंक यू नो दॅट वर्किंग ऑफ सच काइंड्स ऑफ वॉल्स. ओके, वेन वी रोटेट दिस वॉल्स क्लॉकवाईज, हा क्लॉकवाईज आपण ज्यावेळेस फिरवतो, ऍट द टाइम दिस पाईप विल गेट क्लोज, अँड वेन वी ओपन रोटेट दिस वॉल अँटी क्लॉकवाईज इट विल गेट ओपन. ओके, सो दिस बेसिक थिंग आय थिंक यू शुड नो, यू नो दॅट व्हेरी वेल. So now here I will start the pump. Okay, and then we will take the readings. Now, when we do the practical at that time, such kind of technical problem, it will be observed that water is not coming through the pump. Okay, why it happens? Because air may be have entrapped inside this casing or impeller. त्याच्यामध्ये एअर जर असेल तर पाणी मोटर ओढणार नाही. ठीक आहे, त्यासाठी आपल्याला काय करावं लागेल? वी हॅव टू डू द प्राइमिंग ऑफ द पंप. पंपचं आपल्याला प्राइमिंग त्या ठिकाणी अगोदर करावं लागेल. ठीक आहे, सो व्हॉट इज द मिनिंग ऑफ प्राइमिंग? प्राइमिंग ऑफ द पंप मीन्स वी हॅव टू फिल दिस पार्ट ऑर द केसिंग ऑफ द पंप विथ वॉटर सो दॅट एअर बबल विल गेट रिमूव फ्रॉम दिस केसिंग. यातून हे एअर बबल पूर्णपणे रिमूव्ह जाईल. So that water will again, the pump can suck the water and it will flow inside. So I am going to close this pump now. Okay, and I will do the priming of this. I will fill up this pump with water, casing of the pump with water, and then we will start so that water will come inside this. Okay. So I am going to fill it. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you can see here, the water has started flowing through this bypass valve. Okay, return pipe. Now, when I close this by rotating in clockwise direction, you can observe there is a decrease in the water in this bypass valve. Okay, bypass pipe. Now, water has started entering inside this tank. And it can be observed here. I have closed this wall also here, and you can observe there is a rise in water level in this piezometric tube. Here also you can see. So now I will start this wall here. I will open it because water level has rise. You have to maintain the balance here. I will close this pipe partially. After reaching this water level at certain point, we will make it stable. Now check here whether it has become stable or not. It's rising, right? So what I will do? I will open this valve somewhat. I think it is has become stable now. Check here whether it has become stable or not. Check here also. It has become stable. Now we can check down the reading. Now here you can observe this piezometric water levels in the piezometer. Here water level is maximum. It is somewhat lesser, smaller. Here it has gone on decreasing. It is the smallest rise in the water level. Means pressure head is very low here because cross section area is low here. Velocity will be maximum at this particular point. Okay. And here it has again gone increasing. So you can observe here this concave shape like curve like this here. Okay. If you join this point, you will observe curve there. Now here, you have to note down the readings. Okay. And I will tell the reading. One by one, all these readings you have to note down from point number one. Okay. So note it down. Here in the cube number one, note down the reading. 19.4. It is 19.4. Then in cube number 2, it is 19. Cube number 3, it is 18.8. Cube number 4, it is 18.4. Cube number 5, it is 16.6. Are you writing the readings?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Cube number six reading is 15. Cube number 7, it is 11.7 or 11.8. Cube number, how many is now? 8. The reading is 12. Cube number 9. The reading is 14. Cube number 10. The reading is 15.3. Then cube number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Cube number 6. 11. The reading is 16. Cube number 12 is not working here. Cube number 13. Or you can write, give the name for this cube as a cube number 12. Okay. The reading is 16.2. Cube number 13. The reading is 16.3. Have all of you wrote the readings here? Reading you directly again. Now we are going to measure the discharge. Okay. This is a measuring tank. In this measuring tank, Now I am going to close this wall. A wall yadi kani bandh kele. Then we will observe here rise in the water level. You can see here one more piezometric tube is there. Okay. At 40, I will take it as an initial reading 40. Then we will take 70 or 80, or we will take here 70. So 40 to 70. This is the 30 centimeter. Okay, this is the 30 centimeter height we are going to take here to rise the water. This 30 centimeter, how much time it will take? That we are going to measure with the help of stopwatch. Okay. One minute here now. I have not started the stopwatch. Let the water go down. The stopwatch. There is a stopwatch, right? Now I will count here. You can note down, just note down the readings. Okay. On behalf of you, I will measure here the time required to rise the water level from 40 to 70. If it is taking too much time to rise the water level, then we will reduce that height. Now it has come near to put start. So you can see the reading there, 25.92, means near about 26 seconds are time required. You can take on the time. So in the observation table of discharge, okay, discharge measuring table, there in the height column, you can write down the height as a 30 centimeter, 70 minus 40, that is 30 centimeter. And time required, time taken as a 26 seconds. Okay. Now this is one run. Ek run aplya yadi kani jala, ek reading jale. Ata second reading aplya yadi kani gyaycha aahe. We will increase or decrease the discharge. Here I will increase the discharge some more. Can observe here it has rising. So now here I will also increase the discharge here to maintain the discharge uniformity here. We have to make it stable. I think it has become stable now. Yes. So you can note down the readings now. In run number 2, you have to note down the reading. 24. For the first, it is 24. Then for the second, 23.8. For the third, 23.5. Fourth, 22.9. Fifth, 20.5.
6, 18, 7, 13.5, 8, 14, then 9, 16.9, then 10, it is 18.8, 11, 11, it is 19.5, 12, it is 20, and 13, 20.1. Okay. So these are the readings for the pressure head for the run number 2. Now here we are going to measure the discharge for the second run. So I will close this wall once again. And we will measure the time required here to rise the water level by the same height, that is 30 centimeters. I have to start the stopwatch. You cannot simultaneously see both the things. Start. Stop. The time has come 22.37 seconds. I will open this wall. So now I will stop this pump. Okay. In this way, we have to perform the practical. So now, what is the time right now? 2:30. Okay. Am I audible to all?
Yes, sir.
So just now we have conducted the practical, this verification of Bernoulli's theorem. Has everyone understood how it is performed? Has everyone noted the readings that I have told? Now, first of all, do the calculation for the discharge. And if you are having facing any doubt, you can ask right now. Do the calculation and tell me the values. Are you doing the calculation part? One more thing I would like to tell here, I have forgotten there. All the readings you have taken, these are readings in the centimeter or it is centimeter only, not in mm. So you have to convert that centimeter unit to meter by dividing that centimeter value by 100. That correction, that thing you have to do there. in discharge measuring table we have written there the rise in water level as a 7 cm, right? 30 cm, I think, from 70 to 40, that difference we have taken, right? So that is 30 mm actually. So that convert that 30 mm to meter by dividing it by 1000. So you will get that rise in water level as 0.03. Okay, are you getting my point?
Dividing by 100.
No, that reading is in mm. Okay, discharge is reading to me 30 cm. It is not 30 cm. It is 30 mm difference. 30 cm म्हणजे एक एक फूट झालं जवळपास. तेवढे राईज केली का आपण त्याच्यामध्ये? नाही केलेली. दॅट वॉज इन mm. सो डू इन कॅल्क्युलेटर 30 / 1000 यू विल गेट 0.03 meter. And here, rise in water level. प्रत्येक ठिकाणी किती येईल? 0.03. या ठिकाणी पण 0.03. दोनच रन केलेत आपण, तिसरं केलेलं नाही आहे. दोन रन. व्हॉल्यूम, व्हॉल्यूम काय करायचं आहे? दिस मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 0.03. 0.1215 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 0.03. It is coming
0.03364.
3.645 into 10⁻³. I will write it small. 3.645 × 10⁻³. Are you getting the same value or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Pile reading se time kitne?
26 seconds.
Okay. Now, divide this value volume by 26.
1.40 × 10⁻⁴.
So this is the discharge of first reading. Okay. 1.40 × 10⁻⁴ meter cube per second. Okay, to have some understanding about this, you can convert this meter cube per second to liter per second by multiplying it by 1000. So it will become 0.14 liter per second. Okay, eka second madhe evde liter pani tethun bahir padat hot pipe madhun. 0.14 liter per second. Then second reading, this volume will be same, nothing has changed. And time is how much? It is
22.37.
Okay, divide this value.
1.62 × 10⁻⁴.
It has come
1.629 or 63.
Round up we can take here 63 × 10⁻⁴
meter cube per second.
Okay, so this is our first calculation. Okay, next table for calculation of total head. Now here you have written this value, pressure head value, that values you have written in centimeter, that also you have to convert that in meter by dividing it by 100, because all calculations are convergence are in meter. So that's why that value should be written in meter. Just give 2 points before that value. And then we have to find out the velocity. How to find out this velocity? whatever the discharge, it has come there. What is the discharge of the first reading?
1.40 into 10 to the power minus 4.
1.40 into 10 to the power minus 4. Now we have to divide this discharge. What is the formula of velocity? It is equal to discharge divided by area. So area is area ne aplyala tya thikani divide karayche. Right. So find out. Now power 10 to the power 4, both are same there in the numerator and denominator. So directly you can just write 1.4 divided by 8. You will get the velocity. So the velocity for the first section, it has come 0.175. Are you getting the same value?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Then for the second, 1.4 divided by 7. Instead of 8, now here 7. It has come 0.2. This is the velocity. And for the third, divide it by 5. 0.28. Then for the fourth, divide it by 4. 0.35. Next divided by 3, it has come 0.467. Next divided by 2, the velocity has come 0.7. Next divided by 1.8, velocity has come 0.778. Then divided by again same value, you will get the same velocity, 0.778. Again here 2.5, 0.56, 3.5, 0.4. And last one is the 5. So already I have written there for the 5, 0.28. So these are the velocities that we have got at various sections.
Sir, 12 and 13 reading.
Yes?
12 and 13 reading.
12 and 13, you can note it down or skip that last two readings because we don't have the cross section area, I think. Or wait. In the manual I have in that, let me check whether cross section area of that is given there. In the...
इलेवन परेंसेस आहेत अकरा परेंसेस घ्या
नाव फाइंड आउट द वेलोसिटी हेड काय करायचं आता या ठिकाणी पहिले व्हॅल्यू किती आले प्लीज 0.17 आहे का ते
हो सर 1.75
1.4 डिवाइडेड बाय 8 राईट 0.175 नाव मेक इट स्क्वेअर 0.175 square divided by 2z 2 into 9.81 bracket complete is equal to 1.56 into 10 to the power minus 3 हे बसते का बघा याच्यामध्ये किंवा तुम्ही आता जरा मोठं केलं असतील कॉलम पेनी लिहिताय तर त्यात बसेल अशी प्रत्येकाची या ठिकाणी हेड चे व्हॅल्यू या ठिकाणी लिहा 2z देन 0.2 स्क्वेअर डिवाइडेड बाय 2 इंटू 9.81 2.038 into 10 to the power minus 3. प्रत्येकाच्या जे मजर 10 टू द पॉवर मायनस 3 येत असेल तर ते मायनस 3 या ठिकाणी कॉमन मध्ये लिहून ठेवा 10 टू द पॉवर मायनस 3. ठीक आहे, आणि याच्यामध्ये फक्त व्हॅल्यू लिहा 2.03 1.56 लाईक दॅट. देन डेटम हेड यू कॅन चूज इट एज अ 1 meter. ऍज पाईप इज हॉरिझॉन्टल इट विल बी सेम फॉर ऑल सेक्शन्स 1 meter. ओके, अँड ऍट लास्ट व्हॉट यू हॅव टू डू, you have to do the addition of this pressure head, then this velocity head and this datum head. ya tini chi addition karaychi ni ti ya tikan lech, you will get here something 1 point something value in meter. That values you note it down here. Similarly for the run number 2,
सर टोटल हेड पर सांगा.
टोटल हेड इज नथिंग बट इट इज द एडिशन ऑफ प्रेशर हेड, हा तुमचा रो, त्यानंतर हा वेलोसिटी हेड, 3 नंबरचा रो आणि 4 नंबरचा रो, याची ऍडिशन. प्रेशर हेड, वेलोसिटी हेड, डेटम हेड, देन यू विल गेट द टोटल हेड. म्हणजे इथलं रीडिंग प्लस हे रीडिंग आणि हे रीडिंग यू विल गेट दिस व्हॅल्यू. डू इट. Tell me the total head for whatever the sections, it will get completed within these 2 minutes. I have taken your attendance just before few minutes. I have taken the screenshot of your attendance. Last minute is remain. Similarly, do the calculation for run number 2. You can tell your answers, whatever the calculations you have done, in our next coming session, lecture or practical. I think tomorrow we have the lectures, in that we can do the calculation and tell me the readings. That calculation. Okay. Yes, anyone? Has found the total heads. Okay, time is over. Now we'll stop here. You can tell your calculation part later on in the next coming lecture. So we are stopping here. So thank you to all for your active participation and patience listening. Thank you.